Alright, what's up guys? Daniel Tamago here. Welcome to Vlogo number 11. So today is the 11th consecutive day that I've uploaded a video, which is absolutely insane. But anyways, as you guys saw from the timestamp earlier, today's episode was actually shot about a month ago, back when I was still having my finals exams as a final year business student.
And I'm gonna transition you guys to the video right now.
So yep, enjoy.
And action! What's up guys, Daniel Tamago here and welcome to episode 3, season finale of the Study in NUS series. So this is a 3-part series in collaboration with the NUS Academic Programs Business Unit, designed specially for the international students coming here to study at NUS. So in the past 2 episodes, we actually showed you guys around the different food and accommodation options here in NUS. And in today's final episode, we're gonna discuss the 3rd most commonly asked question, which is, what are the different study spots here in NUS? A special shout out to all the lovely NUS students who actually gave me their recommendations. And actually, one really good suggestion is, can you go and rate all the different study spots in school? So that's exactly what we're gonna do in today's video, and let's go check it out. Alright, starting to drizzle right now, so let's go and hide in the shelter. So anyways, right now we're here at the Education Resource Center, the ERC. So it has 4 stories, the ground floor, level 1, level 2, and right now we're here at the roof. So this is my favorite study spot in my opinion. This is the Yen and Peony Ferguson study. So I've already filmed myself studying here for like 1,000 times already, but why not just add a few more, right? Right now we're gonna go inside. Just imagine you are me, we're gonna go in and study, and let's go check it out. That's right, seats are really competitive here at the Education Resource Center, especially when it comes to the exams period. We're here right now at the ERC Level 2 study areas, which is my second favorite study spot here at NUS. And nope, still no seats. But don't worry, there are also a ton of other study spots outside, and woo, ERC is such a vibe. Located on level 1 of the ERC are 3 different computer commons with a mix of open and semi-enclosed spaces, as well as private meeting rooms for students who wish to have group project meetings. We're here right now in the Mac Commons, and as the name suggests, there are a ton of Mac computers for students to use if they need to. And if my memory hasn't failed me, the other 2 computer commons at level 1 are the PC Commons, which has a whole range of Windows computers and study spots for students to use. Let's go check it out. And this is my favorite part about ERC, man. I'm really, really tired from studying and need a break. I'll see you guys after a short nap. Alright guys, so that's about it for the Education Resource Center. As you guys just saw, it's extremely beautiful and it's easily my favorite study spot in the whole of NUS. Well, okay, it just started raining. You guys can see this is like the perfect study mood ever. Go inside, get a nice coffee. It's warm and cozy inside. You just sit there and study the entire day, okay? Starting to hit me already. So the only problem with this place is the seats are really competitive, as you guys just saw. Right now we are filming at like 8 plus AM in the morning, and it's almost completely filled out. So when I come here to study, I usually arrive at around 8 AM, and before the doors open, there will be like a long queue outside already. So you have to go in and chop your seat. And if you're lucky enough to get a seat over here, you're gonna stay here the entire day. You're not gonna leave this place. You're gonna study all the way. So right now we're gonna go and explore a few other secret study spots here in U-Town. That went from 0 to 100 real quick. Like it was literally sunny just like 1 minute ago, and then look at that. Welcome to Starbucks. Alright, so right now we're here at the entrance of NUS University Town. As you guys saw in the previous episode, the Food Hunt, this is actually Fine Food, and Food Click is over there, or Flavors at U-Town. So there are also a few other secret study spots above Fine Foods over here and below Food Click over there. So right now, we're gonna go and take a look. Let's go. Welcome to the SRC, the Stephen Variety Center. So right now we're actually heading downstairs, and from my understanding, there's another study spot over there. It's not air conditioned, but it's relatively cool over there, and there's like a barber over there. You can go and get a haircut after you study. Yeah, so we're gonna check it out. So as you can see, like, this is like outside the lecture theater. So there's like a few lecture theaters over here, and oh, it's actually really cooling. Like, the wind actually flows through this tunnel over here. Okay, so on our right, we are actually driving past Yale. Yep, this is Yale on the side. Whoa, Yale NUS College. So the Yale NUS Library looks a bit like the Hogwarts Library. It looks very magical, and it's a very nice place to study. Okay, so we've pretty much exhausted all of the study spots in U-Town. So right now, we're gonna try to explore more of the libraries in NUS. And in fact, one of the most popular suggestions that students gave was the CLB, the Central Library. So I think one of the students mentioned that the CLB is at FASS, and it recently was renovated, so it's like really nice right now. And a lot of people have been telling me, like, go to CLB level 5.5. So I have no idea what that is. I've never been to the CLB before. So right now we're gonna check it out. Have you been to the CLB?
Dude, I literally don't study. Why am I even in this video? You know, I have like literally zero value add on like studying, eh.
Fun fact here, right? Jax and I, we actually did a day in a life video, right? And the whole video had zero studying inside.
It's all B-rolls, you know?
It's just pure sense. Alright, so anyways, right now we're heading over to CLB. I'm the only one that can enter the library because I'm the only one here with a student pass. So the film crew is gonna chill for a while. I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna give you guys a rating whether it's a good place to study at. Okay, aside from Central Library, are there any other libraries?
There's Biz Lab, which I never go as well.
No, Biz Library is the only library you have went because it's like right opposite the hall.
Yeah, I have no choice because I have to print stuff sometimes. Like,
oh yeah, you can print stuff in the library.
Out of necessity, but not out of like need to study lah.
So if you guys need to print stuff, you can actually print them in the library. The library actually has like a printing room. Every time we have like report submissions or I need to print lecture notes, we always go there to do our printing. Oh my gosh, look at that, CLB. Oh, this place is massive eh. This is like the National Library of Singapore. Just look at all that knowledge. Alright, see you guys.
Hey, bye Tom. Have fun studying.
Wow, you look so bright. What's his name?
You look like the rapper, the Korean rapper. The one who hosts the American Idol.
J-Park. 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 Okay, thanks bro. J-Park. Sorry, how to go up to the library?
Okay, J-Park. I bring you.
First time here. Oh, you bring me here. I'm a celebrity.
Which level do you want to go to?
5.5. Alright, so that's a wrap for CLB. I was walking down, you know, the whole stretch, right? It's like one full stretch of students studying. Then they're common thinking like, what the heck is this guy doing? Okay, so anyways, I managed to find a seat over there. There are a lot of seats, so I think that goes to show like, okay, the seats are not as competitive as like the Education Resource Center. Let us know in the comment section, like, so far, which is your favorite study spot. Anyways, right now, we are heading over to Techno Age. So yesterday, when we were here to do our food review, we actually chanced upon the Starbucks over here, which is really, really nice. Right, so this is my third cup of coffee for today, and it's only like 12 noon, so this is my final cup of coffee. Okay, so I think overall in general, it's a bit hard to give like a rating to like the study spot because I think different students have different preferences on like the kind of places that they like. For example, a lot of students had recommended the Central Library to me, but to me, it felt a little bit too National Library-ish with the white lights and everything. For me personally, I need like a study location that has a really strong vibe like the Education Resource Center. So yeah, it's a bit hard to give a rating, but I think in general, the most intuitive way to rank it is whichever study spot is like the most convenient for you, so that you can make it sustainable, you can consistently go to the same place to study all the time. So for example, if you stay in like student dorms or halls, the most convenient ones would be like the reading rooms, the common study lounges. As you guys saw in episode 1, the lounge areas, like, they are really, really nice. If you live in these student dorms, there's absolutely no incentive for you to go all the way out of school to study. So I think the second best option is in the faculties, which is closest to home for you. So for example, for me, I'm from NUS Business School, so the Moshtar Riady building, which is the business school building, that's like the best study spot for me. And finally, if all else fails, the best option is definitely at U-Town. You guys saw this morning, it's like the most beautiful spot to study in school. But one thing for sure is the seats are really, really competitive. So if you guys want to go and study there, you have to go early, queue up and choke the seats. So yeah, that's about it. I think I'm going to wrap up the section over here for studying. Studying in NUS is not all about studying and studying and studying. There's a lot of other activities that we can do. So we're going to have lunch right now, and after that, we're going to send it. Let's go. We'll be right back. Alright guys, so right now we're here at the MPSH, which stands for the Multi-Purpose Sports Hall. So fun fact, this place used to be an examination hall where we used to take our finals exams. So this place would always be crowded with a lot of people. You can see people studying before their exams outside here. So this place literally has every single sport that you can think of. And if you are a student at NUS, you can go online and book it. And aside from the fitness gym here at the MPSH, the most common gym is actually the one at U-Town. So since that's the most convenient gym for most students, usually it gets really, really crowded. So sometimes there will be like a long queue outside of the gym. But that's really my favorite gym. I go there really often to get a workout in, and sometimes after studying straight away I'll go to the gym and I'll go back to study. So above the U-Town gym, there's also an infinity pool that overlooks the U-Town field. It really looks like the one at Marina Bay Sands. So as long as you are a student of NUS, you can just tap in with your matriculation card and you can just go there and chill, have a nice swim overlooking the U-Town field. And speaking of the U-Town field, a lot of students always have a lot of activities there as well. You can go there and play frisbee with your friends, play soccer, or even if you want, you can just go there and have a ski dipping session with the birds this morning. That's pretty much it for the activities in NUS. So I hope you guys enjoyed joining us for a full day of rating study sports as well as doing a few activities within campus. So yesterday when we were filming episode 2 at the NUS Supper Stretch, it's not even NUS one, right? It's just Supper Stretch.
Common
Supper Stretch near NUS. So we noticed across the road under the overhead bridge there was this cordoned off area, and then there were like a few people inside. They were like shooting stuff. So Jax and I, we actually went to take a look. It was actually an archery range. Jax and I, we actually booked a slot for today. Right now we are actually going to try it out. This is our final activity to wrap up this video. Yeah, I guess we're just gonna send it.
Correct.
Yeah, okay.
I mean, like, just send it.